jamah kami semua malam ini.
With your presence,
dengan hadiratmu.
Touch us with your glory.
Jamah kami semua dengan kemuliaanmu.
Lord, deposit your presence.
Mari Tuhan depositkan hadiratmu.
Fill us tonight, Lord.
Penuhi kami sekarang Tuhan.
With your presence.
Dengan hadiratmu.
Our homes need your presence.
Rumah kami perlu hadiratmu.
For our cities need your presence.
Kota kami juga perlu hadiratmu Tuhan.
Father, fill us tonight.
Tuhan, penuhi semua kehidupan kami.
With overflow.
Dengan suatu yang melimpah.
Overflow.
Melimpah.
Overflow.
Melimpah.
Overflow.
Melimpah.
Make us hungry for your presence.
Buat kami semua semakin bertambah haus akan firman-Mu.
Desperate for your presence.
Buat kami sangat menginginkan semua hadirat-Mu.
Holy Spirit,
Roh Kudus mari.
We invite you tonight.
Kami mengundang-Mu malam ini.
To come,
datang,
and touch every single person.
Dan jamah setiap daripada kami.
That we will forget ourselves.
Supaya kami lupakan diri kami
sendiri. We will forget ourselves.
Kami akan lupa dengan diri kami sendiri. Masalah yang menjadi terlalu persoalan lagi.
Lord, we do not matter.
Tuhan, semua tidak ada yang menjadi masalah.
You matter.
Karena cuma Engkau lah yang
your penting. Your presence matter.
Hadirat-Mu penting
your
buat kami.
Your glory matter.
Hadirat-Mu penting buat kami.
Your presence matter.
Hadirat-Mu penting buat kami.
Fill us tonight.
Penuhi kami malam ini.
In the name of Jesus. To be here tonight.
Saya sangat bersuka cita ada di sini malam ini.
I want to share tonight.
Saya mau sharingkan buat saudara malam ini.
You know how to understand God's presence.
Bagaimana kita boleh sungguh-sungguh mengerti hadirat Tuhan?
If we understand God's presence,
kalau kita sungguh mengerti hadirat Tuhan,
our life will change.
Hidup kita pasti berubah.
It doesn't matter what we face.
Apapun yang kita hadapi itu tidak masalah.
It doesn't matter. Go through.
Apapun yang kita alami itu tidak menjadi persoalan.
The greatest key is to understand God's presence.
Kunci yang terbaik, yang terbesar adalah mengerti hadirat-Nya.
About 30 years ago, almost 30 years ago.
Kurang lebih 30 tahun yang lalu.
I was about 22 years old.
Waktu itu umur saya kurang lebih 22 tahun.
I just came out from the military in Singapore.
Baru lulus daripada akademi militer di Singapura.
And the Lord. I came out into full-time ministry.
Dan saya masuk dalam pelayanan sepenuh waktu.
And when I came out into full-time ministry,
dan waktu saya masuk dalam pelayanan sepenuh waktu,
I was praying and I said, Lord,
dan saya berdoa dan saya berkata, Tuhan,
I want you to teach me.
Saya mau Engkau melatih aku, mengajar aku.
What is the most important thing?
Apakah hal yang paling penting?
And at that time,
dan waktu itu,
there was a massive revival in China.
Ada suatu kebangunan roh yang sangat besar di China.
And the Lord told me,
dan Tuhan berkata kepada saya,
I want you to pack your bag.
Saya mau engkau kemasi barang-barangmu.
Buy a one-way ticket.
Dan beli tiket satu jalan saja.
And go to China.
Dan pergi ke China.
So I went to China.
Dan saya pergi ke China.
Because I heard so many stories.
Karena saya mendengar begitu banyak cerita.
About what God was doing in China.
Apa yang Allah lakukan secara luar biasa
and
di China.
I wanted to know why.
Dan saya mau sungguh-sungguh mengerti kenapa Tuhan melakukan ini di China.
So that gave me the privilege.
Dan itu memberikan saya suatu kehormatan.
Within the first month,
dalam bulan yang pertama,
I was praying together with the Chinese Christians on the mountaintop.
Berdoa bersama-sama dengan orang Kristen di China di puncak suatu bukit atau gunung.
You know, they met at 5:30.
Mereka bertemu jam 5:30. Dan selama 3 jam
they prayed in the spirit.
Mereka terus berdoa dalam roh.
And after 3 hours,
dan setelah 3 jam
they just thank you Jesus, thank you Jesus.
Mereka berkata terima kasih Yesus, terima kasih
Yesus. 3 hours,
3 jam, bayangkan semua.
After 3 hours, hours of hugs. 3 hours of thank you, Jesus.
3 jam lagi berterima kasih sama Tuhan.
And then 3 more hours.
Dan kemudian 3 jam lagi.
They pray
mereka
for their city.
Untuk kota mereka.
9 hours.
9 jam mereka berdoa.
They pray.
Mereka terus dan tetap berdoa.
I have never been in a meeting like that.
Saya belum pernah dalam pertemuan seperti itu.
On the top of a mountain.
Di puncak gunung.
Not in an air-conditioned building.
Bukan di tempat yang ada AC-nya.
So after that meeting.
Setelah pertemuan
we
itu.
We came back to the city.
Dan kita kembali ke kota.
So I asked them.
Dan saya bertanya kepada mereka.
Tell me. Can you tell me?
Apakah kau bisa beritahu saya?
What is God doing in China?
Apa yang Tuhan lakukan di China?
So the one of the leader tell me.
Dan seorang pemimpin itu langsung mengatakan kepada saya.
There is two category of what God is doing.
Ada dua jenis hal yang Tuhan lakukan di China.
He said there is number one.
Yang pertama.
Ordinary category.
Adalah hal-hal yang biasa.
Ordinary.
Hal-hal yang biasa.
I said, what is ordinary?
Yang biasa itu kayak apa saya bertanya.
There were about 15 leaders in that room.
Ada kurang lebih 15 pemimpin di ruangan itu.
He said, every single person.
Dan saya katakan mereka, setiap orang dari mereka.
Have raised the dead.
Pernah membangkitkan orang mati.
They have come back to life.
Dan mereka bangkit kembali dalam hidup.
So I ask him.
Dan saya bertanya.
Is this ordinary?
Ini loh hal yang biasa.
Or extraordinary?
Ini hal yang biasa atau luar biasa?
Then he said.
Dan dia katakan.
Oh, this one only ordinary.
Oh, yang ini cuma biasa.
So I sit there.
Dan saya duduk di sana.
And I said, this one ordinary.
Saya bilang yang ini kayak gini biasa.
This normal.
Ini biasa normal.
I walk away.
Saya langsung pergi.
I walk away.
Saya pergi.
Because I'm from Singapore.
Karena saya dari Singapura.
I never see this one.
Saya belum pernah lihat yang ini.
I only see people in church sleep.
Saya cuma lihat orang di gereja tidur.
All sleep, come church sleep.
Banyak orang datang di gereja tidur.
Pray meeting sleep.
Pelayan-pelayan dalam waktu pertemuan doa tidur.
I only see resurrection during preaching.
Aku cuma melihat orang bangkit waktu khotbah dan tidur maksudnya.
So I walk away.
Dan saya langsung pergi.
I scared to ask. I scared to ask.
Saya bahkan terlalu takut untuk bertanya.
If that is ordinary.
Kalau itu hal biasa.
What is extraordinary?
Apa yang hal yang luar biasa?
So after 10 minutes.
Setelah 10 menit.
I come back.
Saya kembali.
See, that is ordinary.
Benar yang tadi itu yang biasa.
What is extraordinary?
Kalau itu yang luar biasa.
Siapa?
Mereka katakan.
In the morning.
Di pagi hari.
Go to the mountain to
pray. Kami pergi ke atas gunung untuk berdoa.
Sometime,
kadang-kadang,
the Chinese army,
tentara di China,
come and surround the mountain.
Dan datang mengepung mengelilingi gunung.
They have instruction.
Mereka punya suatu perintah
to shoot us.
Untuk menembak kami.
But when they come on the mountain,
waktu mereka datang di puncak gunung,
and they see us pray.
Dan kami cuma berdoa.
Behind every Chinese Christian,
di belakang setiap orang Kristen,
there is an angel.
Ada seorang yang menutup menaungi.
When they see the angel,
waktu mereka melihat malaikat,
they know.
Dan mereka mengerti.
This is God.
Ini adalah dari Tuhan yang benar.
This is God.
Ini Tuhan.
They go back to their village.
Dan mereka kembali ke kampung mereka.
And the next day.
Dan keesokan harinya.
They bring their family.
Mereka bawa keluarga mereka.
To join this prayer meeting.
Dan mengundang mereka doa ini.
This is extraordinary.
Ini yang luar biasa.
So I ask God. Why is this happening in China? And this is what he said. He said, because they carry a different presence. Unusual become normal.
Sesuatu yang sangat dahsyat sebenarnya menjadi biasa saja.
I believe.
Saya percaya.
What I saw 30 years ago.
Dan apa yang saya lihat 30 tahun yang lalu ini.
I believe as we get closer and closer.
Waktu saya mulai makin mendekat dan semakin dekat.
The coming of Christ.
Kedatangan daripada Tuhan.
That this will become normal.
Dan ini akan menjadi hal yang biasa. Haleluya. Biasa.
Normal.
Biasa.
Every church here, it will become normal.
Semua yang luar biasa ini akan menjadi biasa.
So today,
karena itu malam ini,
we want to talk about understanding the presence of God.
Saya mau kita belajar mengerti rahasia daripada hadirat Tuhan.
We want to look at some scripture.
Kita akan lihat beberapa ayat.
As our reference.
Sebagai contoh.
In John chapter 17,
dalam Yohanes pasal 17,
verse 22 and verse 23,
ayat 22 dan ayat 23,
Jesus prayed.
Dan Yesus berdoa.
He said, Lord, you give me the glory and I give the glory to them.
Dan Tuhan Yesus berkata, Tuhan Bapa, Kau sudah memberikan kemuliaan-Mu kepadaku dan Aku sudah berikan kepada mereka.
Lord, I'm going to give them your glory.
Tuhan Bapa, Kau akan memberikan kemuliaan-Mu kepada mereka.
Jesus.
Yesus datang,
that we carry His glory.
Supaya kita membawa hadirat-Nya.
Jesus came.
Yesus datang,
that we encounter His glory.
Supaya kita mengalami perjumpaan dengan kemuliaan-Nya.
Experience His presence.
Dan kita mengalami benar-benar hadirat-Nya.
See, when you look at the Bible,
waktu saudara lihat kepada Firman,
the presence of God is very normal.
Dan hadirat Tuhan itu menjadi sesuatu yang sangat biasa.
It is not something unusual.
Itu bukan hal yang luar biasa.
You know, if you look in the Bible in the book of Genesis,
kalau saudara lihat dalam kitab Kejadian di Alkitab,
the Bible says that Adam heard the sound of God.
Dan katakan Abel mendengar suara dari Tuhan.
He heard the voice of God walking in the night.
Dia mendengar suara Tuhan berjalan-jalan di taman.
This is normal.
Ini hal yang biasa.
Normal. This is nothing exceptional.
Ini bukan sesuatu yang luar biasa. Ini cuma sangat biasa. Dia mendengar dan dia tahu waktu Tuhan datang. Waktu Tuhan datang dalam hadirat-Nya,
something change.
Sesuatu berubah di atmosfer.
Something change.
Sesuatu berubah.
See, as believers,
sebagai orang percaya,
we must learn to recognize.
Kita perlu belajar untuk mengenali
when God comes.
Ketika Tuhan datang.
When He comes.
Waktu Dia datang.
You see,
saudara dengar. Waktu hadirat-Nya menjadi makin tebal.
When is the glory becoming heavier?
Waktu kemuliaan-Nya menjadi semakin berat.
Because as we press in,
sekarang ketika kita terus mau maju,
the presence will change.
Hadirat-Nya akan berubah.
And if we respond in the right way,
dan kalau kita respon dengan cara yang benar,
we can see the supernatural.
Kita akan melihat hal yang supernatural sama seperti hal natural saja.
Why?
Kenapa?
Because that's the time God is moving.
Karena waktu itu adalah waktu yang Allah bergerak bekerja.
Few months ago,
beberapa bulan yang lalu,
I received a phone call.
Saya menerima suatu telepon.
And you know, I live in a city called Tampa.
Saya tinggal di suatu kota yang namanya Tampa.
And a friend of mine called me.
Dan seorang teman saya menelpon saya. Dan dia berkata,
there is a lady. She runs a university.
Dan ada seorang wanita yang mengerjakan atau punya pelayanan suatu universitas.
This morning she find out she have cancer.
Dan pagi ini dia baru tahu kalau dia kena kanker.
And stage number 4.
Dan itu stadiumnya udah 4.
And the doctor don't give him much time.
Dan bahkan dokter kata waktunya tinggal sedikit.
And he said, can you pray for her?
Dan dia dikatakan, bisa kamu berdoa bagi dia?
And she lived in another city 2 hours away.
Dan dia tinggal di kota yang 2 jam jauh perjalanan.
From where I am.
Dari tempat saya ada.
So he called me and said, can you pray for her?
Dan dia berkata, apakah kau bisa berdoa bagi dia?
And then I said, okay, I will pray for her.
Dan saya kata, okay, saya akan berdoa.
So I put the phone down.
Dan saya taruh teleponnya. Waktu saya taruh teleponnya,
the Holy Spirit said,
dan Roh Kudus langsung berkata,
not tomorrow,
bukan besok,
now,
sekarang.
I want you to pray for her now.
Aku mau berdoa dia sekarang.
I said how?
Jadi Tuhan gimana?
She lives 2 hours away.
Itu jauhnya 2 jam.
How am I going to pray for her?
Bagaimana saya bisa kesana untuk membantu?
The Holy Spirit said,
dan Roh Kudus berkata,
if you
kalau engkau berkata sekarang,
I will perform now.
Saya akan lakukan sekarang.
So I called.
Dan kali itu saya telepon temanku.
I said,
saya katakan,
I have to pray now.
Saya harus berdoa sekarang. Now. Sekarang.
So I said, can you call the lady?
Dan saya bilang, kau bisa telepon wanita itu?
And she called the lady.
Dan dia telepon wanita itu.
And the lady said,
dan wanita itu berkata,
I am in the car.
Saya di mobil.
Driving towards the pastor's city.
Saya mau pergi ke tempat.
I am driving, not.
Oh, dia menyetir mobil dan mau ke kota tempat saya.
She said she is actually coming towards me.
Dia datang untuk menjenguk saya, menjumpai saya.
Long story.
Dan cerita panjang.
Very short.
Buat kependek.
The woman completely healed.
Dan wanita itu 100% sembuh.
Completely healed.
100% sembuh.
No more cancer.
Tidak ada lagi kanker.
What am I saying?
Apa yang saya mau katakan?
You see, there is a, the presence of God.
Ada hadirat Tuhan.
Needs a response.
Perlu suatu respon.
When you don't respond,
waktu kita tidak respon,
you miss the presence. You miss the presence.
Kita akan kehilangan hadirat.
You cannot miss the presence.
Kita tidak bisa kehilangan
kesempatan. And the presence comes.
Waktu hadirat itu datang,
you must respond.
Kita perlu respon.
Another example. We see also in the book of Genesis.
Dan kita telah lihat dalam kitab Kejadian.
In the life of Abraham.
Dalam hidup Abraham.
We see this in Genesis chapter 18.
Dalam Kejadian pasal 18.
You can go back and read.
Saudara bisa pulang dan baca.
The Bible says.
Dan Alkitab berkata.
One day Abraham was in the fields.
Dan suatu hari Abraham di suatu ladang.
And suddenly he saw God's presence come.
Dan dia tiba-tiba melihat hadirat Tuhan itu datang.
Three persons.
Bahkan tiga makhluk, tiga pribadi itu datang.
And you read your Bible.
Bahkan saudara baca firman
Tuhan. The Bible tells you.
Alkitab menjelaskan.
That the spirit was going towards Sodom and Gomorrah.
Dan roh itu sedang pergi lewat kepada arah Sodom dan Gomorrah.
It wasn't coming to Abraham.
Itu enggak datang kepada Abraham.
It was just passing by.
Itu cuma sedang mau lewat saja. Tapi waktu Abraham melihat hadirat itu, dia lari.
He ran to the presence.
Dia lari mendekat hadirat itu.
And he said.
Dan dia berkata.
And he knew that they were passing.
Dan dia tahu itu cuma lewat.
So he told.
Dan dia.
The spirit of God. He told the presence. You know, he told when the presence of God comes.
Dia mengejar hadirat itu.
And he told them.
Dan dia beritahu mereka.
Can you wait?
Bisakah kau berhenti?
Can you stay?
Bisa kau tinggal?
I know you are going.
Saya tahu kau sedang pergi.
Can you stay?
Tapi maukah kau
tinggal? Let me give you a little water.
Biar saya izinkan saya memberikan sedikit minum.
Can I want to give you a little bread?
Dan aku mau berikan sedikit roti.
Please sit under this tree.
Mari silakan duduk di bawah pohon ini.
Can you imagine?
Saudara bisa bayangkan?
Spirit of God sitting under the tree.
Roh Kudus duduk.
The Bible says,
Alkitab berkata,
Abraham ran.
Abraham lari.
Ran to his wife.
Lari kepada istrinya.
He said, I want you to make a cake.
Dan aku mau buat engkau suatu roti.
The wife said,
dan istrinya berkata,
when?
Kapan?
Now.
Sekarang.
And then he ran.
Dan dia lari lagi.
To the guy who was in charge of all the sheep.
Dan punya orang yang boleh tanggung jawab buat semua.
He said, I want you to make a barbecue.
Then I come go what's on the barbecue.
So the guy said, barbecue takes 6 hours.
Barbecue for the man jam.
Because must marinate the meat. Abraham tell him, no time. You have 5 minutes.
I want the barbecue.
I want the barbecue. Why? Because the presence of God. What am I saying? When the presence comes, if you don't see the presence, the presence of God. You must feed the presence.
So
whoever that is up here, whether it's a worship leader, whether it's an elder, whether it's a leader, when he gave an instruction, you must respond to the flow of the Spirit. You must respond. After they ate, they blessed Abraham. You see, your response will determine your miracle. Your response will determine your blessing.
Correctly,
you will miss your miracle. This is very important, because the presence of God does not wait. It doesn't wait for anybody. We must recognize when it comes. We must respond. We also see in the life of David, for example.
Kita akan melihat dalam kehidupan Daud sebagai contoh.
David also understood the presence of God.
Daud adalah seorang yang mengerti hadirat Tuhan.
One time,
suatu hari, Alkitab berkata,
he was going to go to battle.
Dan dia mau pergi dalam suatu pertempuran.
And the Lord told him,
dan Tuhan berbicara kepadanya,
don't move.
Jangan bergerak. Sampai kau mendengar suara
on the mulberry tree,
dari pohon-pohon murai.
When the mulberry tree moves,
ketika pohon murai itu mulai bergerak,
you move.
Saudara, Anda itu bergerak.
The tree moves.
Kalau gerakan di pohon itu,
you move.
Engkau bergerak,
you win.
Saudara pasti menang.
Wow. Can you imagine?
Saudara bisa bayangkan?
Can you imagine?
Saudara bisa bayangkan?
You know, David is a fighter. So he is waiting.
Dan dia menunggu.
And his commander.
Dan komandannya
asking him.
Dan memberitahu dia.
What are we waiting for?
Apa yang kita tunggu ini? Apa yang tunggu raja?
The enemy there.
Itu musuh di sana.
We are here.
Kita di sini.
We have knife.
Kita punya senjata.
What are we waiting?
Kita ini nunggu apa?
I can imagine what David said.
Dan saya bisa bayangkan Daud berkata.
I am waiting.
Saya menunggu.
For the tree to
saya menunggu pohon murai bergerak.
When the tree moves,
waktu pohon bergerak,
then we move.
Kita juga akan bergerak.
Can you imagine?
Saudara bisa bayangkan?
His commander probably think.
Dan tiba-tiba jenderal Daud mungkin berpikir,
this guy a little bit
Orang ini pasti sedikit gila.
What do you reckon? Apa ini kamu? If you move,
kalau saudara bergerak,
before God moves,
sebelum Tuhan bergerak,
you move alone.
Saudara bergerak sendiri.
But if you wait,
tapi kalau saudara menunggu,
for God to move,
sampai Allah bergerak. Saudara juga bergerak,
revival will come.
Kebangunan lagi pasti datang.
Revival will come.
Kebangunan lagi pasti.
Why?
Kenapa?
Because you follow the move of the Spirit.
Karena saudara mengikuti gerak.
You follow the move of the Spirit.
Saudara mengikuti gerak.
We must understand.
Kita perlu mengerti.
How God's presence.
Bagaimana hadirat Tuhan bekerja berfungsi.
You see, we must have a spirit of yielding.
Kita perlu punya hati atau roh yang sungguh-sungguh berserah.
No questions.
Tidak mempertanyakan sama-sama.
Too many questions.
Tidak nanya terlalu banyak.
Just follow.
Cuma mengikuti.
Just follow.
Mengikuti.
Just follow.
Mengikuti. Daripada
Rasul. When I first went to China,
ketika saya pertama kali ke China,
you know, many people say,
dan banyak orang berkata,
why you go China?
Kenapa sih lu pergi ke China?
You are not Chinese.
Kau bukan orang Chinese.
I said my stomach Chinese.
Saya bilang perutku minimal orang Chinese.
Because I like Chinese food.
Karena saya suka makan makanan Chinese.
They ask me.
Dan mereka bertanya,
why you go?
Kenapa you go pergi?
I also don't know.
Saya juga tak tahu.
I just obey.
Saya cuma taat saja.
Because my goal when I went to China.
Karena target saya, tujuan saya pergi ke China.
At that time, many people become Christian.
Karena saat itu banyak orang jadi Kristen.
In one town.
Dalam satu kota kecil.
25,000 become Christian every day.
25,000 orang jadi orang percaya setiap hari.
One town every day.
Setiap kota kecil setiap hari.
So the Chinese government don't allow them to have Bible.
Dan karena itu pemerintah China tidak izinkan mereka punya Alkitab.
So the Lord told me, I want you to smuggle Bible.
Dan Tuhan kata, aku mau kau menyelundupkan Alkitab.
You know, my whole life I never smuggled.
Saudara, so, seumur hidup saya tidak pernah menyelundup.
First time.
Pertama kali.
Smuggle Bible into China.
Saya menyelundupkan Alkitab.
So when I learn how to smuggle.
Pada waktu saya belajar bagaimana menjadi penyelundup.
I learn one thing.
Saya punya satu hal.
Become.
Saya seperti anak kecil.
I said Holy Spirit.
Sudah Roh Kudus.
I don't know.
Saya tidak tahu.
Teach.
Ajar saya.
How?
Bagaimana?
How to do this?
Bagaimana saya bisa mengerjakan?
So.
Dan terlalu.
Every day I hear.
Setiap
the voice of the Holy Spirit.
Roh Kudus berkata.
And follow.
Dan saya mengikuti.
Smile.
Menyelundup.
So after 1-2 months,
setelah 1-2 bulan,
I have many success.
Saya banyak kali berhasil.
Many success.
Saya sering kali berhasil.
So one day I had a team of 20 people.
Dan satu hari saya punya tim dari 20 orang.
So I was the leader.
Saya adalah pemimpin.
They came to me and they said, teach us how to smuggle.
Dan mereka datang saya ngajarin kami dok cara menyelundupkan Alkitab.
I said number one.
Nomor satu saya katakan.
Become a child.
Menjadi seperti anak kecil.
What do you mean?
Apa maksudmu?
I said you don't know what is going to happen today.
Saudara tidak tahu apa yang terjadi hari ini.
But the Holy Spirit know.
Tapi Roh Kudus tahu dengan jelas.
Ask him.
Tanya dia.
How many Bible today you must read?
Berapa banyak Alkitab yang hari ini saya harus
baca? How many bag you must carry?
Berapa tas yang saya harus bawa?
What clothing you must wear?
Pakaian seperti apa yang saya harus
bawa? Everything.
Setiap semuanya kita
berbicara.
Dan tim saya berkata,
you crazy.
Engkau memang gila.
How can?
Bagaimana mungkin?
You decide.
Engkau memutuskan.
So I said, never mind. You do your thing.
Saya kata, tak peduli lalu aku
ambil yang lain. So I was standing there.
Dan saya berdiri di
sana. I said, Holy Spirit.
Saya berkata, Roh Kudus. Hari ini.
How many Bible do I take? And the Holy Spirit said,
dan Roh Kudus berkata,
today,
hari ini,
200. So I took the Bible,
dan saya ambil Alkitab,
put in my bag,
taruh di tas saya,
two bag,
dua tas,
and then they look at me,
mereka melihat saya.
Finish.
Selesai dengan lagi.
Finish.
Pasti beres.
This one 100% Gojek.
Pasti kali ini 100% KB.
100%.
At that time. Dan waktu itu.
One page.
Satu halaman.
One page of the Bible.
Satu halaman daripada Alkitab.
6 months jail.
6 bulan penjara.
I had 200.
Saya punya 200 Alkitab.
That means for eternity.
Berarti saya ada penjara untuk kekekalan.
For eternity.
Untuk
so they look at me.
Dan mereka melihat saya.
You are really crazy.
Kamu ini benar-benar gila.
We won't follow you.
Kami tidak mau ikut.
We want to wrap the Bible in aluminium foil.
Kami mau menaruh Alkitab itu membungkusnya dalam aluminium.
And wrap in a cloth.
Dan kemudian dibungkus dalam baju.
I said you have Holy Spirit.
Dan sekarang kamu punya Roh Kudus.
You don't need to wrap.
Kamu tidak perlu bungkus-bungkus.
When you have Holy Spirit.
Waktu kamu punya Roh Kudus.
You don't need drama.
Kamu tidak perlu drama.
Come on.
Halo.
Engkau
tidak perlu.
You have the real thing.
Saudara perlu cuma ikuti.
Understand? You have the real thing.
Saudara punya hal yang benar.
So I ask the Holy Spirit.
Dengan Roh Kudus.
So what I do?
Apa yang saya lakukan?
He said.
Dan dia katakan.
One cloth.
Satu baju.
Only one cloth.
Cuma tutup satu baju.
So the team said.
Dan tim saya berkata.
We won't follow you.
Kami tidak mau ikut.
You go fast.
Pergi sendiri cepat.
We follow from behind.
Kita ikut dari belakang.
So I get to my Bible, I go.
Dan saya bawa Alkitab saya sendiri.
Chinese immigration.
Dan imigrasi China.
And I look at them, they all behind me.
Dan saya lihat mereka semua jauh di belakang.
Very far.
Sangat jauh.
So when I go to the immigration,
waktu saya pergi imigrasi,
I turn around.
Saya lihat ke belakang.
All of them.
Semua mereka.
Look at me.
Melihat pada saya.
Today finish.
Pasti beres.
Finish.
Habis.
So I give my passport.
Saya berikan Alkitab.
To the immigration.
Passport saya kepada imigrasi.
He asked me.
Dan dia tanya.
What do you do?
Apa yang kau lakukan?
So I told him.
Dan saya beritahu.
I am a businessman.
Saya seorang pengusaha.
I never lie.
Saya tidak pernah bohong.
I do my father's business.
Saya lakukan usaha bapa saya.
Then he asked me.
Dan dia tanya lagi.
What business you do?
Apa bisnismu?
So I say import export.
Dan saya bilang import export.
I never lie.
Saya tidak bohong.
Also true.
Itu juga betul.
I import Bible.
Saya mengimport Alkitab.
I export communism.
Saya ekspor komunisme.
Back to hell.
Supaya balik ke neraka.
So import export.
Import export.
So he look at me.
Dan dia lihat saya.
He said.
Dan dia berkata,
open your bag.
Buka tasmu.
No problem.
Tidak ada masalah. Saya buka tas saya.
So then,
dan tiba-tiba,
he put his hand.
Dia taruh tangannya
on the cloth.
Di bajunya.
I turn and see the team.
Saya tidak melihat semua tim saya.
All of them.
Semua mereka.
Finish.
Habis. Sayonara kata Jepang. Habis. Dan tiba-tiba
he talk to me.
Dia berbicara sama
saya. His hand.
Tangannya di Alkitab. Dia bicara.
So I also talk.
Saya juga bicara.
And then
dan tiba-tiba
he said.
Dia berkata,
no need to check.
Gak perlu dicek.
And then he closed the bag.
Dan ditutup tasnya.
He's sick. I'm finished. He's sick.
Dia tutup sendiri.
Then,
lalu
he helped me carry.
Dia bantu saya angkat.
He helped. And then he said.
Dan dia berkata,
wow, your bag very heavy.
Masih ini berat banget dia.
So I tell him.
Karena saya beritahu dia.
Banyak batu.
Banyak batu.
Many stones. And then he look at me.
Dan dia melihat saya.
He shake my hand.
Dia salami saya.
He said.
Dan dia berkata.
Have good business in China.
Milikilah bisnis yang baik di China.
I said, Hallelujah.
Dan saya bilang, Hallelujah. Terima kasih.
I walk away.
Saya jalan.
My team.
Tim saya.
When I turn.
Waktu saya jalan.
All the mouth.
Mulut mereka semua
open.
Semuanya.
What am I saying to you?
Apa yang saya mau katakan sama saudara?
If you want the presence of God,
kalau kamu hendak Tuhan bekerja untuk anda,
don't ask questions.
Jangan banyak tanya.
Just follow.
Ikuti saja.
Just follow.
Kalau saudara berusaha memikirkan,
you won't understand.
Saudara tidak akan mengerti.
Your brain cannot understand.
Pikiran kita adalah sarkos.
Your brain is natural.
Karena pikiran kita cuma hal yang normal.
What God is do is supernatural.
Yang Tuhan lakukan supernatural.
What God needs from you.
Apa yang Tuhan butuhkan dari kita
is obedience.
Adalah ketaatan.
Is he.
Adalah penyerahan diri.
Follow.
Dan mengikuti.
Follow.
Mengikuti.
Follow.
Mengikuti.
When you follow.
Kau mengikuti.
Revival come.
Kebangunan rohani terjadi.
Revival come.
Kebangunan rohani terjadi.
Year 1999.
Tahun 1999.
Taiwan.
Taiwan.
Had a major earthquake.
Ada gempa bumi yang besar.
You can read in YouTube many photos.
Saudara bisa lihat di YouTube banyak fotonya.
2,000 people died in a
earthquake. 2,000 orang mati.
200,000 people lost their home.
200,000 orang kehilangan rumah.
I was praying.
Saya sedang berdoa.
And God told me.
Dan Tuhan beritahu.
I want you.
Saya mau engkau.
Take a key.
Dan bawa timu.
Go to the center of the earthquake.
Pergi ke pusat gempanya.
You know, I'm Singaporean.
Saudara tahu saya orang Singapura.
Singapore no earthquake.
Singapura tu nggak ada gempa.
No, don't have.
Nggak ada.
We don't know what is earthquake.
Kita nggak tahu gempa itu kayak apa.
We don't know what is river.
Kita nggak tahu bahkan sungai itu kayak apa.
Because for us,
karena buat kami,
small drain is river.
Got kecil itu sungai.
Because we have no big river.
Karena kita nggak ada sungai besar.
Oh, river.
Oh, sungai.
When we come to Indonesia,
waktu kita ke Indonesia,
we see the river.
Saudara melihat sungai.
We say, oh my God.
Saya, oh Tuhan.
This one river.
Ini baru sungai.
So when God say, go to the center of the earthquake.
Waktu Tuhan bilang, pergi ke pusat gempa.
I say, wow, very exciting.
Saya, wow, sangat menarik Tuhan.
So I told my young people.
Saya beritahu semua orang muda saya.
We are going to the center of the earthquake.
Kita mau pergi ke pusat gempa.
Can you imagine?
Saudara bisa bayangkan?
All the parents of the young people.
Itu orang tua dari anak muda itu.
Go back and tell their father.
Dan beritahu.
Tell their mother.
Beritahu ibunya.
My pastor.
Pendeta saya.
Want to go to the middle of the earthquake.
Mau pergi ke pusat tangannya gempa.
Why?
Kenapa?
Because he want to dance.
Karena dia mau lari.
Why he want to go center of earthquake?
Kenapa dia mau pergi ke pusat?
I also don't know.
Saya juga nggak tahu.
So we go 14 of us, all young people.
14,
1, 4.
Kami pergi 14 orang dari kami.
19.
13.
Chinese.
Orang Chinese.
Only one.
Cuma satu.
Not Chinese.
Yang bukan Chinese.
So we go.
Karena itu kita pergi.
So when we arrive there,
karena kita waktu sampai,
one Buddhist school.
Dan seorang polisi menelpon.
The school, Buddhist school.
Polisi sekolah.
The building have some crack.
Dan bangunan itu banyak ada retakannya.
This school is in the center of the earthquake.
Dan sekolahnya ada di pusat gempa itu.
And the principal of the school.
Dan kepala sekolahnya.
He meet us.
Dia bertemu kami.
He said.
Dan dia berkata.
You came at right time.
Engkau datang di waktu yang tepat.
Dia huh? Yeah. Right time.
Tepat kenapa?
I said why?
Kenapa?
He said because now earthquake.
Karena sekarang lagi gempa.
All the young people said.
Dan semua anak muda itu sedih, takut.
So next 3 days.
Karena itu 3 hari seterusnya.
I will bring all the young people.
Saya bawa semua anak muda itu.
To the basketball court. Basketball.
Oh, court. Bawa kepada lapangan basket.
And your team.
Dan timnya.
Do your program.
Dan melakukan suatu program.
Whatever you want to do.
Apapun yang kau lakukan.
Hah? I thought, wow.
Wow.
Free.
Ini bebas, bayar, nggak gratis.
Never pay money. No promotion. No publicity. Free.
Semua gratis.
So I call my team.
Saya panggil tim saya.
I said 3 days.
Saya bilang 3 hari.
We can preach.
Kita bisa khotbah.
We have one problem.
Kita punya satu masalah.
I am not Chinese.
Saya bukan orang Chinese.
So I cannot preach.
Karena itu saya tidak bisa khotbah.
You all Chinese.
Engkau semua orang Chinese.
From tomorrow I don't know who preach.
Besok saya tidak tahu siapa yang khotbah.
Maybe you, maybe you, maybe you, maybe you.
Mungkin kamu atau lu.
You pray.
Kita berdoa.
Tomorrow.
Besok.
I decide.
Saya putuskan.
I tell you.
Saya beritahu.
My young people.
Semua anak-anak
muda. I remember one guy.
Saya ingat satu anak muda.
That evening.
Sore itu.
Next morning we have to pray.
Dan besoknya kita ada doa.
He walking in the basketball court.
Dia jalan di lapangan
basket. He praying Pastor. Tomorrow I have to preach.
Aku besok harus berdoa.
I said unless.
Kecuali.
Tomorrow morning,
besok pagi,
if I wake up,
kalau saya bangun,
my skin change,
kulit saya berubah,
to become Chinese,
saya menjadi orang Chinese.
If tomorrow morning,
kalau besok,
if my skin change,
kulitku berubah,
I become Chinese,
saya menjadi orang Chinese.
I preach,
saya akan khotbah.
If not, you preach,
kalau tidak, lu yang khotbah.
He looked at me,
dia lihat saya.
Really crazy.
Really crazy. Gila. Licar gila.
Wah, he prayed.
Dan terus berdoa.
Those 3 days.
Dan 3 hari itu.
My young people.
Anak-anak muda saya.
All revival.
Semua adalah kebangunan rohani.
All revival.
Semua kebangunan rohani.
Because they don't know who pray.
Karena mereka tidak tahu apa itu. Siapa yang berkompas, siapa yang mengajar.
So, 3 days.
3 hari.
You know what happened?
Apa yang terjadi?
We had 2,000 salvation.
Kita punya 2,000 orang menerima keselamatan. 2,000 keselamatan.
The vice president of Xerox was there.
Ada wakil presiden dari Xerox ada di sana.
He's a Christian.
Dan dia berkata Kristen.
He cried.
Dia bilang.
He said 30 years.
30 tahun.
I have been praying for this day.
Aku mau berdoa buat hari ini.
For this day.
Untuk hari ini. Itu terjadi.
Now it happened.
Sekarang itu terjadi.
What am I saying?
Apa yang saya katakan?
If you want the presence
kalau
of God,
kalau mau hadirat Tuhan,
you must follow.
Saudara perlu mengikuti.
You must follow.
Saudara perlu
you
mengikuti.
Don't understand.
Saudara tidak perlu mengerti.
Never mind.
Gak masalah.
Just follow.
Ikuti saja.
Just obey.
Taati saja.
Just do what He tells you.
Kau lakukan saja apa yang Dia perintahkan.
And as you
saudara ikuti dia,
salvation will come,
keselamatan akan datang,
miracle will come,
mujizat pasti datang,
breakthrough will come,
terobosan pasti datang.
Follow the Holy Spirit,
ikuti Roh Kudus,
the presence of God,
hadirat Tuhan.
I also want to show you few more things.
Saya mau tunjukkan beberapa hal lagi.
The presence of God,
hadirat Tuhan,
also flows in different ways,
juga mengalir dengan cara yang berbeda.
We want to understand this.
Dan kita mau mengerti ini.
In John chapter 14 verse 17.
Dalam Yohanes pasal 14 ayat 17.
It says right at the end.
Dan dikatakan di akhirnya.
It says that He will dwell in you.
Dan dikatakan Dia tinggal di dalam Anda.
And He also will be with you.
Dia akan bersama-sama Anda.
He will be in you.
Dia ada di dalam Anda.
With you.
Dan bersama Anda.
Same spirit.
Roh yang sama.
But
tapi
different presence.
Ini hadirat yang beda.
In you.
Dalam kau.
And with you.
Dan bersama kau.
We must understand this.
Saudara perlu mengerti ini.
You see.
Dan saudara berkat lihat.
Presence.
Hadirat.
Free.
Adalah gratis.
Free.
Gratis.
No need to do anything.
Gak perlu ngapa-ngapain.
The presence comes.
Hadirat datang.
It's free, you know why?
Itu gratis kenapa?
Because He said, I will not leave you.
Dia katakan aku gak akan pernah meninggalkan kamu.
Whether you feel or don't feel, He is here.
Saudara merasa atau tidak, Dia tetap di sini.
But power,
tapi kuasa
is different.
Adalah berbeda. different.
I have two children. When they ask me,
hey,
can we spend time with you? It's free.
Itu gratis.
Free.
Anytime.
You want to spend that? Free.
Mau
but if they say,
tapi kalau mereka berkata,
Dad,
Papa,
we want your credit card.
Kami perlu credit card. No.
That one is not free.
Yang satu itu enggak gratis.
Because I have two daughters.
Karena saya punya dua anak perempuan.
If I give credit card,
kalau saya kasih credit card,
tomorrow,
besok,
I cuci piring.
Yeah, I wash the dishes.
I wash dishes.
Saya cuci piring.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Presence.
Tapi
free.
Gratis.
Power not free.
Kuasa tidak gratis.
If power is free,
kalau kuasa itu gratis,
everybody will have power.
Semua orang punya kuasa itu.
Come on.
Halo.
Everybody.
Semua akan punya kuasa itu.
Don't have.
Tapi nggak semua.
Everybody have presence.
Tapi semua punya hati.
Have presence.
Punya hati.
Our king.
Kuncinya
is to understand
mengerti
when
is
presence
hadirat itu
when
kapan
is it power
itu kuasa.
If we understand this,
kalau kita mengerti ini,
our life
kita
will not be normal. You know, we must understand.
Kita perlu dan kita perlu mengerti
when
ketika
is present
hadirat
and when
kapan is
power
itu kuasa.
The Bible says even Jesus,
bahkan Yesus,
he went to some place,
waktu dia ada di beberapa tempat,
he couldn't do miracles.
Dia tidak bisa
because the Bible says
karena kita
unbelief.
Tidak percaya mereka karena ketidakpercayaan.
But the Bible also says.
Tapi Alkitab juga berkata.
In one instance it says. In one scripture it says.
Dalam satu ayat itu berkata.
That God's Spirit was present.
Hadirat Tuhan, Roh Tuhan ada bersamamu.
One on a certain day he was ready to heal.
Dan hari kedua dia siap untuk menyembuhkan.
So it's interesting.
Sangat menarik.
It says that his presence
dia berkata,
was ready to heal on that day.
Siap untuk menyembuhkan hari itu.
This is Jesus.
Ini Yesus.
What am I saying?
Apa yang saya katakan?
We must recognize.
Kita perlu mengerti.
In presence.
Dalam hadirat.
In presence.
Dalam hadirat.
Or with presence.
Atau bersama hadirat.
See, the presence flows differently.
Saudara perlu mengerti, hadirat bergerak, mengalir dengan cara yang berbeda.
In presence,
dalam hadirat,
when we worship,
waktu kita menyembah,
when we praise,
waktu kita memuji,
when we pray,
waktu kita berdoa,
in presence,
dalam hadirat,
comes and envelops us,
datang membungkus kita,
comes and falls on us,
dan datang atas hidup kita.
But there is with presence.
Tapi itu ada hal yang lain bersama hadirat.
Is with presence.
Adalah bersama hadirat.
When with presence comes.
Ketika bersama hadirat datang.
It's coming to perform something.
Itu akan melakukan suatu.
It's coming to bring a breakthrough.
Itu akan membawa satu terobosan.
It's coming to bring a supernatural manifestation.
Akan membawa suatu manifestasi supranatural.
It is coming to bring healing.
Akan datang membawa kesembuhan.
So there is a difference in presence and also with presence.
Jadi kita perlu mengerti bedanya di dalam hadirat.
We must understand this.
Kita perlu mengerti.
Because this is important for us so that we can flow.
Karena ini penting bagi kita untuk kita bisa mengalir.
Because there are dimensions of God's presence.
Karena ada dimensi daripada hadirat.
You see, that's why.
Itulah sebabnya.
When God told Moses,
ketika Tuhan katakan kepada Musa,
I will go with you.
Aku akan pergi bersamamu.
You know what Moses said?
Saudara tahu apa yang Musa katakan?
I don't want your angel.
Saya enggak mau cuma malaikatmu.
I want you.
Saya mau engkau.
Both are presence.
Dua-duanya hadirat,
but different presence.
Tapi hadirat yang berbeda.
Moses understood this.
Orang-orang yang mengerti ini.
Moses understood.
Musa mengerti.
He understood this principle.
Musa mengerti prinsip ini.
There is an angel presence.
Ada hadirat malaikat.
But there is also Holy Ghost presence.
Tapi ada hadirat Roh Kudus.
So, how do we see this increase in our life?
Bagaimana kita bisa melihat hal ini makin bertambah dalam hidup kita?
The key for increasing this.
Kunci daripada penambahan ini.
Is that no matter what happens.
Apapun yang terjadi.
Whether there is a manifestation.
Ada manifestasi.
Whether there is healing.
Ada kesembuhan.
Whether there is a supernatural miracle.
Ada hal-hal supranatural terjadi.
There are three things that are very important.
Ada beberapa hal yang sangat penting.
Number one.
Hal yang pertama. Curi kemuliaan.
Don't steal the glory.
Jangan curi kemuliaan.
When you steal the glory,
waktu saudara curi kemuliaan,
the breakthrough will stop.
Terobosan itu akan berhenti.
Because the glory,
karena kemuliaan,
is meant for Jesus.
Karena itu ditujukan cuma satu-satunya buat Yesus.
He must be exalted.
Dia saja yang harus
diangkat. He must be lifted up.
Dia saja yang harus disembah.
So for the presence to increase.
Karena itu untuk hadirat makin bertambah.
Learn to give him the glory.
Belajar mengembalikan semua kemuliaan bagi dia.
You see, in Indonesia.
Soalnya di Indonesia.
You know, in the 60s and 70s, many revivals.
Tahun 60-70 banyak kebangunan rohani.
I know that because I was a young Christian.
Saya tahu karena saya adalah
orang muda. All over the place.
Saya pergi ke banyak
tempat. And I remember.
Saya ingat.
Many moves of God.
Gerakan Roh Kudus begitu banyak.
And the church was so amazing.
Gereja begitu luar biasa.
Oh, it's so powerful.
Sangat perlu dengan kuasa.
The presence of God was so thick.
Karena hadirat Tuhan begitu tebal.
But as the churches began to grow.
Tapi waktu gereja makin besar.
You know, the denomination became more important than Jesus.
Denominasi menjadi lebih penting daripada Yesus.
Oh,
halo.
The pastor became more important than the Holy Spirit.
Gembalanya jadi lebih penting daripada Roh Kudus.
This is a problem.
Ini jadi masalah. Halo.
Money became more important than people.
Uang menjadi lebih penting daripada manusia.
Come on.
Halo.
Very quiet now.
Sekarang jadi diam semua.
So what happened?
Apa yang terjadi?
It entered into a season.
Ketika dia selesai dalam satu musim.
It became religious.
Menjadi suatu cuma gaya agamawi.
Agama religious is not the people.
Ini bukan manusia lagi.
But because the focus was missed.
Karena fokusnya berganti.
Focus was shifted.
Fokusnya tidak didapat.
You see, I like this.
Saya suka ini.
You know why?
Kenapa?
Because this
ini
has a focus of Jesus.
Fokusnya pada Yesus.
There is a hunger of Jesus.
Ada ratusan Yesus.
A hunger.
Oh, ada haus akan Yesus.
Jesus.
Akan Yesus.
You know why I say that?
Kenapa saya katakan?
Because if there is no hunger,
karena kalau nggak ada haus,
nobody will come at 4:30.
Gak akan ada orang datang setengah lima.
4:30.
4:30.
Most people.
Banyak orang.
Are in third heaven.
Ada di surga tingkat tiga, saudara.
Third heaven.
Surganya udah tingkat tiga.
Playing music.
Main musik.
Yang lain.
Ngerti saudara? Sorry.
Different.
Lain.
Yes.
Yeah.
But when there is hunger.
Tapi waktu ada haus.
Very easy.
Sangat mudah.
Very easy.
Sangat mudah.
There is one church.
Ada satu gereja.
In Korea today.
Di Korea hari ini.
I love to go there.
Saya suka pergi ke sana.
Because there is hunger there.
Karena ada haus.
You know when I go there to preach.
Waktu saya pergi ke sana.
I go there at 12 o'clock.
Saya pergi jam 12.
Afternoon.
Siang.
The pastor give me the microphone.
Pastor yang berikan saya mic.
At 7 p.m.
Dikasih ke saya jam 7 malam.
7 p.m.
Jam 7 malam.
You know why?
Kenapa sudah tahu?
Because they worship for 6 hours.
Karena mereka menyembah.
6 hours they worship.
6 jam
menyembah. With the baby.
Dengan anak bayi. Di dada.
They jump. 6 hours.
6 jam.
The most exciting place.
The
Korea.
Y el palo de la Corea.
Is that church?
Abre la derecha de tu.
You
know
why? Hungry.
House.
Very hungry.
Sarah.
When there is hunger,
what do abre house and sound?
You no need to force.
So
you
don't have to massa.
No need to push.
Gabriel Toro.
People will come.
Ora
I pray.
Say
that you will take the presence in this meeting.
Saudara ambil hadirat di dalam pertemuan ini.
Go back home.
Waktu saudara pulang.
And change your prayer.
Dan mengganti cara doa.
Change your devotion.
Cara ganti cara doa.
Don't go back to normal.
Jangan cuma jadi orang yang biasa.
Change.
Jangan ganti.
What you saw here.
Apa yang anda lihat di sini.
Bring it back to your
home. Pulang ke kotamu.
Bring it back to your
home.
Everything will start changing.
Dan semua akan berubah.
Because
karena
of your hunger,
kehausanmu,
and your desperation.
Karena kedesperasian.
Wherever God is moving,
ketika di mana pun Allah bekerja,
people are praying.
Orang-orang berdoa.
People are responding.
Orang-orang respon
to the move of God.
Dalam gerakan Tuhan.
There is one group that we work with in China now.
Ada satu grup yang bekerja sama dengan kami di China.
Every day,
setiap hari,
they pray.
Mereka berdoa.
At 4:30 in the morning.
4:30 di pagi.
Until 8:00.
Sampai jam 8.
Every single day,
setiap hari.
You know why?
Sebab kenapa?
Because they are hungry.
Karena mereka haus.
For the presence of God.
Untuk hadirat Tuhan.
When we are hungry,
waktu kita haus,
the presence will increase.
Hadirat akan bertambah.
Number one. Don't steal the glory.
Jangan curi kemuliaan.
Number two.
Yang kedua.
Keep pressing in.
Terus bergerak maju.
Pressing in.
Terus bergerak
more
maju.
And lebih. More.
Lebih.
And more.
Lebih lagi.
And more.
Lebih lagi.
And more.
Lebih lagi.
So the presence will increase
over your life. Over your life.
When it increases over your life,
hidupmu,
everything around you will change.
Semua sekitarmu akan berubah.
Your family will change.
Semua akan berubah.
Your lifestyle will change.
Gaya hidup akan berubah.
Your friends will change.
Orang akan berubah.
Everything will change.
Semuanya berubah.
Why?
Kenapa?
Because the presence of God.
Karena hadirat Tuhan.
Will effect change.
Akan membuat satu perubahan.
Bring change.
Akan membawa satu perubahan.
Akan membuat suatu impact. Because when you carry that presence,
karena waktu ketika anda membawa hadirat itu, tidak bisa tetap tinggal.
Let me go a little bit deeper.
Kita mau masuk lebih dalam.
The presence of God.
Hadirat Tuhan.
There are three levels of the presence of God.
Tiga level hadirat Tuhan.
The first level of the presence of God.
Yang hadirat Tuhan level satu
is what we call blessing presence.
Adalah hadirat yang memberkati.
Blessing presence. Let me give you a scripture for that.
Saya memberikan ayat buat saudara.
So that you don't think that I'm just rambling on here.
Jadi saudara nggak pikir saya cuma ngarang-ngarang.
I want to give you some scripture so that you understand.
Saya berikan ayat supaya saudara mengerti.
That there is a basis for this.
Ada suatu basisnya.
Because when we understand the basis for this,
kalau kita mengerti dasarnya,
in 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 6 and verse 9,
dalam 2 Samuel pasal ke-6, ayat ke-6 dan ayat yang ke-9,
David was bringing God's presence.
Dan Daud membawa hadirat Tuhan.
He was bringing the ark.
Dia bawa tabut
into the city of David.
Dan mau pergi ke kota.
But as he was bringing it,
tapi waktu dia bawa ke kota,
he put it on a car.
Dia taruh di kereta.
He put it on the wrong vehicle.
Dia taruh di dalam kendaraan yang salah.
And this thing almost fell.
Dan mau jatuh.
There was a young man called Usa. He put his hand.
Dan ada seorang anak muda yang Usa dia taruh.
When he put his hand,
waktu dia taruh tangannya,
zap,
langsung,
instantly he died.
Tiba-tiba mati.
David became afraid.
Daud menjadi sangat takut.
And he saw that.
Waktu dia lihat itu,
he said, I don't want this presence.
Aku tak mau hadirat ini.
I'm scared of this thing.
Aku takut hadirat.
If I bring it to my city,
kalau aku bawa ke kotaku,
tomorrow all night,
semua besok mati.
I am a king with no people.
Saya jadi raja tanpa rakyat.
So he looked around.
Dan dia lihat ke sekeliling.
Where can I put this?
Saya bisa taruh di mana?
And then he saw one house.
Dan dia lihat satu rumah.
Obed-Edom house.
Romania open a door.
So he called
Obed-Edom.
This one, put in your house. Can you imagine?
You
know, he carried
it
to his house. His wife asked
him,
what is this? This is God's presence. You mean this thing just now killed somebody? You want to bring this into the house? You know, over here, maybe have children. Can you imagine he tell the children? Don't touch.
Jangan sentuh.
Will the children follow?
Kira-kira anaknya nurut ya?
100% no.
Pasti saudaranya nurut.
You know, next morning,
besok pagi,
the children will be on the box.
Anaknya pasti naik dia pasti.
Hi, Father.
Halo.
Bye-bye.
Mati.
So I can imagine.
Saya bisa bayangkan.
Okay, you know. Take this box.
Bawa kotak ini.
Bring into the deepest room.
Bawa ke
into the room.
Bawa ke satu ruangan.
And close the door.
Dan tutup pintunya.
And put wood.
Dan taruh kayu.
And nail.
Dan paku.
All the
semua tutup.
All window.
Dengan ada jendela.
He tell his family.
Dan dia kasih tahu.
Don't touch.
Jangan pegang.
Even the doorknob don't touch. The doorknob.
Jangan bahkan pegang tombol pintunya. Jangan pegang.
So David forget.
Dan Daud lupa.
Forget.
Daud lupa.
So few months later.
Berapa bulan kemudian.
David is on a horse.
Dan Daud lagi naik kuda.
He's going through the city.
Dan dia pergi ke kota.
Harvest time already finished. Harvest finished.
Oh, musim menuai sudah selesai.
So he goes.
Sudah selesai.
Is it all harvest or nothing?
Bagi orang sudah semua nggak ada.
And then suddenly.
Dan tiba-tiba.
He go by one house.
Dia pergi ke satu rumah.
He saw the corn.
Ada suatu jagung.
Very tall.
Tingginya sampai ke.
And the corn look like monster.
Dan jagungnya kayak monster.
And then he said.
Dia berpikir.
Very big. He call me bang. Special.
Special.
And then he go a little bit further.
Dan dia maju lagi.
He see the cow.
Dia lihat sapinya.
And then he go back.
Dan dia mundur lagi.
This one cow or Goliath?
Ini nih sapi atau lembu mas?
Hey, you see?
Wow,
so big.
Gede banget.
So he call his people.
Dan dia panggil orangnya.
Whose house is this?
Rumah siapa ini?
He said, you remember?
Kau ingat?
Obed Edom.
Rumahnya Obed Edom.
Now no more Obed.
Gak udah gak ada lagi Obed.
Now Ogud Edom.
Now Ogud Edom. Gak ada lagi. Jelek maksudnya sekarang bagus.
Ogud Edom.
Ogud Edom.
You mean?
Engkau maksudnya?
This is where?
Ini tempat.
I put the presence.
Saya hadirat itu.
3 months ago.
3 bulan lalu.
Because the Bible say.
Karena kita berkata.
For the next 3 months.
3 bulan kemudian.
Everything he touched was blessed.
Apapun yang Obed Edom sentuh.
Everything
he touched
was blessed.
Diberkati.
What am I saying?
Apa yang saya katakan?
The first level.
Level pertama.
Of God's presence.
Hadirat Tuhan.
Is blessing.
Adalah presence. Hadirat yang memberkati.
He will bless you.
Dia akan berkati Anda.
Bless you.
Berkati Anda.
He wants to bless you.
Berkati Anda.
He wants to increase your blessing.
Dia mau menambah berkatmu.
You see, after a while in your relationship with Jesus.
Setelah kita berhubungan cukup lama sama Yesus.
You no need to ask.
Saudara tak perlu minta.
You no need.
Tak perlu.
You only think.
Saudara cuma pikir.
You think.
Saudara pikir.
He give.
Dan dia berikan.
You only think.
Cuma saudara pikir.
Father,
Bapa,
I. Before you say me.
Waktu kau kata aku perlu, belum ngomong perlu.
Wow. God blessing.
Itu adalah berkah.
Blessing.
Berkah.
You know why?
Kenapa?
Because the Bible say every good and perfect gift comes from Him.
Karena Allah pada setiap pemberian yang baik dan anugerah sempurna datang dari Dia.
No need to beg. Hari ini hari terakhir.
Today is your last day.
Hari ini hari terakhir.
Don't cry.
You know what you say? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I am free.
Sayapelas.
Let my people go.
Izinkan umatku pergi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Why you not say?
Kenapa lu gak sedih?
I have no reason to be sad.
Aku gak punya alasan sedih.
Because I carry blessing presence.
Karena aku membawa hadirat yang memberkati.
Blessing presence.
Hadirat yang memberkati.
The favor and the goodness of God.
Kebajikan kemurahan Tuhan mengikuti.
Follow me. Because the presence of God.
Karena hadirat Tuhan.
Will draw favor.
Akan menarik kemurahan.
Blessing.
Kemurahan.
Draw to you.
One
time.
Satu kali.
You know I've been to Myanmar many years.
Saya pergi ke Myanmar berapa kali.
One time we went.
Dan satu kali kami
pergi. And the immigration long crowd, many crowd.
Dan ada banyak orang.
And outside, people standing outside.
Dan orang berdiri di luar.
At least to go through the immigration maybe 2 hours.
Perlu lewat imigrasi itu mungkin 2 jam.
So I was standing there.
Saya berdiri sana.
And I said, Lord, very hot day.
Dan Tuhan bilang, Tuhan, hari ini panas.
Suddenly.
Tiba-tiba.
The immigration officer come.
Pelayan imigrasi datang.
And he hold my hand.
Dan dia pegang saya.
He said, you.
Kamu.
Come.
Datang.
He bring me. To the front.
Dibawa ke depan.
He take my passport.
Jangan masuk saya.
He give to the guy.
Dia beri kepada orangnya.
Stand.
Coba bincang.
Stand.
Jang.
Give me. Everybody see me.
Semua lihat saya.
Who this guy?
Semua ini siapa?
Nobody know.
Gak ada yang tahu.
So then,
lalu,
he hold my hand.
Dia pegang lagi.
Come.
Nah.
He go to the back.
Dia pergi ke belakang.
He said, which one your bag?
Mana tasmu?
I said, that one.
Sedang itu.
Okay, he take my bag.
Dia ambil saya.
He bring me to coffee shop.
Dia bawa ke coffee shop.
And he said,
dan dia berkata,
you sit here.
Kau duduk sini.
And you wait for your people to come.
Kau tunggu orang mau datang.
I sit there. I sit at the coffee shop.
Saya duduk di coffee shop.
And then I drink coffee.
Sampai minum coffee.
2 hours later.
2 jam kemudian.
All my team come.
Tim saya datang.
And when they come,
waktu mereka datang,
they ask me,
mereka tanya,
who is that guy?
Who is that guy? Siapa dia?
Who is that guy?
Siapa dia?
I said, I don't know.
Saya tak tahu.
I don't know.
Saya tak tahu.
Why he bring you?
Kenapa dia bawa anda?
It's too hot.
Karena panas.
You know, my skin.
Lihat kulit saya.
Don't like hot.
Tidak suka panas lagi.
Many Christians always pray.
Banyak orang
Kristen. More fire.
Api lagi.
More fire.
Api lagi.
I never pray more.
Saya tidak pernah bilang api lagi.
Already too much.
Sudah terlalu banyak apinya sebenarnya.
Already too much.
Sudah terlalu banyak.
I always only pray. Holy Spirit, more glory.
Nah, saya cuma doa Roh Kudus, kamu yang lebih.
Fire, give him.
Api kasih dia.
Don't give me, I have enough fire.
Saya sudah punya cukup.
I only want glory.
Saya cuma mau kemuliaan.
If more fire,
kalau api lagi,
I become Africa.
Saya jadi orang Afrika.
And then if I come here,
kalau saya datang sini,
no light,
tidak ada lampu,
you cannot see me.
Saya tidak bisa melihat saya.
Only you see my gigi.
Cuma melihat gigi saya.
You only see the gigi mu.
Ya, only see my gigi.
It's a big problem.
Dan dari masalah itu.
So I always say, Lord,
karena itu saya selalu berkata Tuhan.
Lord, fire, you keep.
Api nggak mau Tuhan, Tuhan simpan.
You keep. Give me glory, glory.
Jika saya kemuliaan, kemuliaan.
What am I saying?
Apa yang saya katakan?
You carry blessing, presence.
Saudara membawa hadirat yang memberkati.
Blessing,
hadirat yang memberkati.
Whatever you want.
Dimanapun saudara inginkan.
Whatever you want.
Apapun yang kau inginkan.
Your Father knows.
Bapamu tahu.
Your Father knows.
Bapamu tahu.
Your Father knows.
Bapamu tahu.
You know, you very easy.
Itu sangat mudah.
You know, Father.
Bapa.
Like children.
Sangat suka anaknya.
Yes.
Yes.
Father like children.
Bapa sangat suka anaknya.
Whenever I'm with my children.
Waktu saya sama anak saya.
You know.
So,
sometimes they go out.
Kadang-kadang mereka keluar.
They want to buy something.
Mereka mau beli sesuatu.
They never open their mouth.
Mereka tidak pernah buka mulut.
They only turn.
Mereka cuma berbalik.
And look at me.
Dan lihat saya.
With these eyes.
Dengan matanya.
I did my what?
Say what? Robert said.
Go.
I don't even know what you're doing.
If I,
kalau saya,
earthly father,
Bapak jasmani,
earthly father,
Bapak jasmani,
can have feeling for my children,
anak saya,
imagine heavenly.
Bayangkan Bapak di surga.
Imagine
bayangkan
heavenly father
di surga.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
How much he loves you.
Bagaimana dia tidak
mengasihi. How much he loves you.
Bagaimana dia tidak lebih mengasihi.
He has no partiality.
Dia tidak punya pembagiannya terhadap.
No partiality.
Tidak ada cuma
all dia. His children
semua
the same.
Anaknya sama.
Sama.
The
blessing presence will come.
Berkat dia memberkati.
Number two.
Yang kedua.
It's called manifest presence.
Hal kedua adalah
when you grow in the presence of God.
Hadirat Tuhan yang dimanifestasikan ketika saudara bertumbuh.
You will shift.
Saudara akan pindah
from blessing presence to manifest presence.
Jadi hadirat yang dimanifestasikan.
Blessing will continue.
Berkatnya tetap.
Continue.
Tetap terus.
But you don't focus on blessing.
Tapi saudara fokusmu berubah.
You focus on manifest presence.
Fokusmu pada perhadiran yang dimanifest.
Let me give you some scripture for that.
Saya berikan ayat.
Some scripture for manifest presence.
Buat hadirat yang dinyatakan.
Because we must understand this.
Karena kita perlu mengerti.
John chapter 14.
Yohanes pasal 14.
Verse 21 and 22.
Ayat 21 dan 22.
It says, and I will manifest myself.
Dan dikatakan aku akan menyatakan diriku.
And he says you will manifest yourself.
Dan dikatakan engkau akan menyatakan dirimu.
See, no more just blessing.
Bukan cuma berkat.
But now it become manifest.
Tapi sekarang menjadi dimanifestasikan.
No more feeling.
Bukan cuma perasaan.
But now become reality.
Sekarang menjadi suatu kenyataan.
Reality.
Kenyataan.
This is deeper blessing.
Dalam.
This is now you know God.
Ini ada datang.
You see God.
Saudara lihat Tuhan.
Experience God.
Saudara mengalami Tuhan.
God's life is one with you.
Dan hadirat-Nya hidupnya ada bersama.
No more just blessing, blessing,
bukan berkat saja, berkat saja.
But
tapi
become manifest presence.
Nyatakan dengan terbuka.
The anointing
urapan
is not just in you,
bukan cuma di dalam anda,
it becomes with you.
Ada bersama anda,
with you,
bersama anda.
It starts manifesting.
Ini adalah hadirat.
Wherever you go,
kemanapun kau
it
pergi,
it starts to manifest.
Itu terus dimanifestasikan.
Why? Because he said, I will manifest myself.
Karena dia kata, aku akan menyatakan
diri. I will manifest myself.
Saya akan menyatakan diriku.
So the second level is manifest.
Yang level kedua adalah dimanifestasi.
When now you see the reality of Jesus,
waktu saudara melihat kebenaran daripada Yesus,
you begin to encounter Jesus.
Waktu saudara sungguh-sungguh berjumpa,
you begin to experience Jesus.
Saudara mengalami Yesus.
Your hands will touch him.
Tanganmu akan memegang dia.
Your eyes will see him.
Matamu akan melihat dia.
Your heart will feel him.
Hatimu akan mengalami
dia. Your body will know him. Every part of your being is now entering a different
arena.
Now you begin to manifest the presence of God. He begins to use you.
Dia pakai saudara.
Wherever you go,
dimanapun anda pergi,
to manifest His glory.
Bagaimana dia menyatakan
manifest His power,
menyatakan kuasa
dia, manifest His presence,
menyatakan hadiratnya. Saya pindah ke Florida satu tahun sekali lalu.
Because God told me to move.
Karena Tuhan suruh.
So when I move, I bought a house.
Karena saya ada di sini rumah.
And I went over to my neighbor's house.
Dan saya pergi ke tetangga.
To introduce myself.
Dan saya kenalkan diri.
So my neighbor is a 74-year-old man.
Tetangga saya umurnya 74 tahun.
And he told me.
Dan dia kasih tahu.
He asked me, what are you?
Kau ini siapa?
I said I am a preacher from Singapore.
Saya ini pakoplah dari Singapore.
I moved here.
Saya pindah sini.
And he tell me.
Dan dia kasih tahu saya.
He said I am 74 years old.
Saya umur 74 tahun.
I have one more So I told him,
saya beritahu dia,
go tell the doctor.
Pergi kasih tahu dokter.
And tell the doctor.
Beritahu dokter.
He will die.
Dia pasti mati.
Not you.
Bukan engkau.
And he looked at me.
Huh?
What?
Apa?
Yes.
Iya.
Tell the doctor.
Kasih tahu dokter.
You won't die.
Kau gak akan mati.
He will die.
Dia akan mati. Yes, sure.
And he tell me.
Jadi beritahu.
My tumor.
Tumor saya.
Is.
Kira-kira segini.
He not Christian.
Dia bukan Kristen.
So then.
Lalu.
I said, I give you teaching.
Saya berikan pengajaran.
I come tomorrow give you teaching.
Saya datang besok.
And I pray for you.
Dan saya doakan.
Okay.
Kira, okay.
So the next day I went to his house.
Besoknya saya datang.
I share all the miracle of Jesus.
Dan saya bagikan semua mujizat Yesus.
All the miracle of Jesus.
Semua mujizat Yesus.
And I said,
dan saya katakan,
Jesus can be.
Yesus bisa sembuhkan anda.
Same Jesus.
Yesus yang sama.
Can touch you.
Bisa menjamah
anda. I pray for him.
Dan saya berdoa.
He
dia nangis.
I ask him.
Saya tanya.
You want to die?
Kau mau mati?
He said no.
Tidak.
You don't want to die?
Kau gak mau mati?
No need to die.
Gak perlu mati.
Really? He said no need. You don't want to die? No need to die.
Kau gak mau mati? Gak perlu mati.
God can heal.
Tuhan bisa sembuhkan.
You believe.
Kau bisa.
You believe.
Kau percaya saja.
One week later.
Satu minggu kemudian.
He called me.
Dia panggil saya.
So excited.
Dengan sukacita.
He said, Richard.
Dan katakan, Richard.
Yesterday I went to the doctor.
Kemarin saya ke dokter.
Two things the doctor said.
Dua hal yang dokter katakan.
Number one.
Nomor satu.
My tumor.
Tumor saya.
From this week.
Dari gini.
Now small.
Jadi kecil.
Become ball of water.
Jadi cuma sangat kecil, cuma seperti bola-bola.
Number two,
yang kedua,
the doctor said,
the doctor berkata,
I no need to die.
Saya tak perlu mati.
I no need to die.
Saya tak perlu mati.
And then he tell me this.
Dan dia beritahu saya ini.
You know, I think.
Suatu kali saya pikir,
God,
Tuhan,
bring you to be my neighbor.
Mengkau menjadi tetanggaku.
To show me what he can.
Menunjukkan apa yang dia sanggup lakukan.
What?
Dengan apa yang dia sanggup lakukan.
This is called manifest presence.
Ini adalah hadirat yang dimanifestasikan.
Manifest presence.
Hadirat yang dinyatakan.
When you go to this level,
waktu saudara pergi ke daerah ini,
your experience will change.
Saudara pengalaman berubah.
Your exposure will change.
Semua kehidupanmu hasilnya
berubah. Your challenges will change.
Tantanganmu juga berubah. Konfrontasimu juga berubah.
You know, many him says this.
Banyak orang berkata.
No, many him.
Oh, many him berkata.
He always say this.
Dia berkata.
He said, wherever there is warfare.
Kemanapun ada peperangan rohani.
There is a miracle.
Ada hadirat, ada mujizat.
There is a miracle.
Ada mujizat.
So at the second level.
Dan di hadirat level ini.
This many people have come to you.
Banyak hal yang terjadi.
Many different challenges.
Banyak tantangan datang.
Why?
Kenapa?
Because God,
karena Tuhan,
want to manifest.
Mau menyampaikan.
He want to manifest.
Dia mau menyampaikan.
He want to show His power.
Kuasa.
He want to show His glory.
Dia mau menunjukkan kuasanya.
Last year,
minggu tahun lalu.
My daughter, 12 years old.
Dan dokter saya 12 tahun.
She had a major accident.
Ada orang yang kena suatu kecelakaan besar.
She fell.
Dia jatuh.
From a pole. She was sitting on a pole and she fell.
Dia duduk satu bangku dan dia jatuh.
When she fell,
waktu dia jatuh,
her spine,
di belakang ini tulang belakangnya.
Number four, number five,
nomor lima,
was compressed,
tertekan,
and the liquid came out,
dan cairan keluar.
Long story,
membuat cerita yang panjang.
She was on a wheelchair.
Dia duduk di kursi roda.
When I brought her to the doctor,
waktu aku bawa dia ke dokter,
the doctor said.
Dokter berkata,
she must have major operation.
Dia harus punya operasi besar.
Maybe she will be better.
Mungkin dia akan lebih baik.
Maybe we
mungkin
don't know.
Kita tak tahu.
We don't know.
Kita tak tahu.
No father like to hear this.
Gak ada orang yang suka mendengar ini.
No mother like to hear.
Gak ada ibu yang suka mendengar ini.
Don't like because your children.
Gak ada yang mau karena ini anak anda.
But then.
Tapi kemudian.
I remember.
Saya ingat.
At 12 years old.
Umur 12 tahun.
I saw my miracle.
Saya melihat mukjizat saya.
And I came became a Christian.
Dan saya menjadi Kristen.
My daughter is now 12.
Then Anna said, "What do I bless her?"
This is her time for her miracle.
He had the baptism of the Moses of Nia.
For her miracle.
Oh, the Moses of Nia.
So I began.
The same way.
All my friends. All
the number one.
All my partners from around the world.
Saya panggil semua partner saya.
I said, pray.
Berdoa.
Pray.
Berdoa.
Because God is going to do something.
Karena Tuhan melakukan sesuatu.
Pray, stand with me.
Berdoa dan berdiri.
You see, for many such presence to work.
Dalam hadirat yang bekerja ini.
You must have faith.
Saudara perlu punya iman.
You must press in.
Saudara perlu masuk
terus. You cannot give up.
Saudara tidak boleh menyerah.
You cannot let go.
Saudara tidak bisa membiarkan.
You cannot amen one day and then tomorrow also.
Dan saudara tidak bisa amin satu hari dan besok tidak jadi.
Every day.
Setiap hari.
You must strengthen yourself.
Saudara perlu kuatkan hidupmu.
In the spirit of God.
Dalam Roh Tuhan.
Every day.
Setiap hari.
You must follow whatever God says.
Saudara perlu ikuti apapun yang
Tuhan katakan. So as I began to pray.
Dan katakan ketika ada
berdoa. I told the doctor.
Saya beritahu dokter itu.
She will be healed.
Dia pasti sembuh.
You know what the doctor said?
Saudara dokter katakan.
Ya. Of course.
Tentu saja.
He is a Baptist.
Dia orang Baptis.
He don't believe in miracles.
Dia tidak percaya mujizat.
He don't believe in signs and wonders.
Dia tidak percaya.
So when I told him that miracle he don't believe.
Waktu saya beritahu mujizat dia tidak percaya.
And we will pray.
Waktu kita berdoa.
One day.
Satu hari.
The Holy Spirit told me.
Roh Kudus berkata.
I got this one.
Saya selesaikan yang ini.
Don't worry.
Jangan khawatir lagi.
Breakthrough is coming.
Proposal itu datang.
It's coming.
Pasti datang.
She will be here.
Dia pasti sembuh.
So I told my wife.
Saya beritahu istri saya.
I told my daughter.
Beritahu anak perempuan saya.
Don't worry.
Jangan khawatir.
You will be here.
Kau pasti sembuh.
It will be done. It will be done.
Pasti selesai.
Next day.
Dan besoknya.
And next day.
Besoknya.
She's still in the wheelchair.
Dia masih di kursi roda.
Going to school.
Pergi ke sekolah.
Come back in wheelchair.
Pulang masih dengan kursi roda.
One day.
Tapi satu hari.
After a few days.
Setelah beberapa hari.
She came back.
Dia datang.
And she said.
Dan dia berkata.
I want to lay down.
Saya mau berbaring.
In the middle of the afternoon.
Dan di sore-sore.
And she lay down.
Waktu dia berbaring.
After that.
Sore itu.
She woke up.
Dia bangun.
And she stood up.
Dan dia bangkit.
Completely healed.
100% sembuh.
Completely healed.
100% sembuh.
So I told her.
Dan saya beritahu.
Tomorrow.
Besok.
We go and see your doctor.
Kita pergi ketemu dokter Anda.
Because we must show the doctor.
Karena kita bertunjukkan
what Jesus can do.
Apa yang Yesus sanggup lakukan.
So I went to the hospital.
Saya pergi ke rumah sakit.
And she, you know, she was coming from behind.
Dan dia ikut dari belakang.
So I told the doctor.
Saya bilang dokter.
Doctor.
Dokter.
She is healed.
Dia sudah sembuh.
You know what he said?
Saudara dokter mengatakan.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh, yeah. Very sorry. Very
oh,
sorry.
Saya sangat minta maaf.
And then suddenly.
Dan tiba-tiba.
She walked in.
Dia masuk.
When he saw her,
waktu dia lihat
in the hospital,
di rumah sakit,
he opened his mouth,
dia buka mulut,
and he shouted,
dan dia teriak,
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Jesus is Lord.
Yesus itu Tuhan.
The Baptist become Christian.
Orang Baptis jadi Kristen sekarang.
On that day,
hari itu.
What am I saying?
Saya katakan apa?
Don't stay in blessing presence.
Jangan tetap tinggal pada berkat.
Manifest. If there is no manifest,
kalau nggak ada pernyataan,
ask God why?
Tanya Tuhan kenapa?
Why?
Kenapa?
Manifest must be normal.
Itu pernyataan itu dimanifestasi.
Normal. In your life.
Dalam matamu.
Why? Because God is with you.
Karena Tuhan bapa
bersama kamu. Most church.
Dan kalau kita adalah gerejanya.
Most church.
Banyak gereja.
Very boring.
Sangat membosankan.
Very boring.
Sangat membosankan.
Three song.
Tiga lagu.
Collect offering.
Ambil persembahan.
Preach.
Apa.
One song.
Satu lagu.
Go home.
Pulang.
Come back.
Balik.
Three song.
Tiga lagu.
Collect offering. They were stoning him.
Peter di Pardo di Le Paris.
But as they were stoning him, Acts chapter 6 says, his face looked like an angel. Because he was transformed. He was changed. The Bible says in Acts 7, when he looked up, it was open heaven. Open heaven. And he saw Jesus standing. Nobody saw. When you are transformed, there is no distance between you and the spirit world. No distance. The spirit world becomes normal to you. What do you mean? You see, when Moses was transformed, the Bible says that Moses wrote the book of Genesis. When you read the book of Genesis, you know that somebody who wrote that, because they saw it, saw what happened. When he was transformed on Mount Sinai, in the spirit, God took him back to the beginning. And we see this about John the disciple. When he was transformed on the island of Patmos, he didn't go backward, but he went forward. Time cannot affect you. What time cannot control you? You can go forward, you can go back. God can show you things nobody sees. One time I was in Korea, and there was a young lady sitting in a meeting.
Ada seorang perempuan muda duduk.
Pray for her. And I went to her. And I said, this is what God said. Today,
hari ini,
resign.
Engkau berhenti.
Tomorrow, you will work for a new company.
Besok kerja buat perusahaan baru.
Everybody is shocked.
Semuanya shock.
Huh? What is he?
Apa yang dia ngomong?
I said, resign.
Saya bilang, pagi.
I go hotel, I go home.
Saya suruh dia berhenti kerja, saya balik hotel.
I don't know who this woman.
Saya tak tahu orang ini siapa.
I don't know.
Saya tak tahu.
2 years later.
2 tahun kemudian.
I went back to that church.
Saya kembali ke gereja itu.
This woman came to me.
Wanita ini datang.
You know what she said?
Dan seorang apa dia katakan?
She said.
Dia katakan.
I am a Korean movie star.
Saya adalah bintang film Korea.
When you came 2 years ago.
Waktu kau datang 2 tahun
lalu. You told
saya untuk berhenti.
I was shocked.
Saya shock.
But when I went back,
tapi waktu saya pulang,
I heard God's spirit say the same thing.
Saya lihat Roh Tuhan mengatakan itu.
So I went back and resigned my company.
Karena itu saya pulang dan saya berhenti.
My company was the biggest movie studio in Korea.
Perusahaanku adalah perusahaan rekaman terbesar di Korea.
And the next day I joined a small company.
Dan besoknya saya bekerja di perusahaan kecil.
She said, you know what happened?
Kau tahu apa yang terjadi?
I have just been given a role.
Saya baru dapat peran.
Few months ago.
Berapa bulan lalu?
To act in a movie called Avengers.
Saya ada di film Avengers.
The only Korean movie star.
Cuma satu-satunya aktris Korea.
That was in the movie Avengers.
Yang ada di film Avengers.
Her name was Claudia Kim.
Namanya Claudia Kim.
And then she told me.
Dan dia kasih tahu saya.
2 days time.
2 hari.
Is the premiere the opening of the field.
Ada pembukaan perdana film itu.
I want you to come with me.
Saya mau kau datang bersama saya.
I don't know what is premium.
Saya tak tahu itu premium itu apa.
I never been to premium.
Saya tak pernah ke premium.
So I call my children.
Saya panggil anak saya.
I said, this woman asked me for premium.
Anak ini sudah pergi premium.
My children.
Anak saya.
Go, go,
pergi,
go.
Pergi, pergi.
She is superstar. Go.
Dia adalah bintang yang terkenal persi.
I said, yes.
Benar.
So the next day,
besoknya,
they pick me up in a Mercedes.
Wah, saya dapat super Mercy.
So I come out from the Mercedes.
Saya keluar dari Mercy.
All the camera people there.
Semua kamera sana.
All take photo.
Semua foto.
I can see their face.
Saya lihat, muka mereka.
They all thinking.
Mereka pikir.
This one Korea.
Ini Korea.
Who this one?
Ini yang satunya siapa?
You know, so I'm thinking.
Saya pikirkan.
You know, this one Hollywood.
Ini Hollywood.
I am not Bollywood.
Saya bukan Bollywood.
I am Heavenwood.
Saya Heavenwood.
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 So when I walk in with her.
Waktu saya masuk.
With her.
Dengan dia.
I walk in like this. I Heavenwood.
Saya
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
What am I saying?
Apa yang saya katakan?
You are so close to heaven.
Saudara dekat dengan surga.
You know what God is going to do.
Tahu apa yang Tuhan mau lakukan.
You know what God is about to do in your city.
Apa yang Tuhan mau lakukan di kotamu.
What God is about to do in your nation.
Apa yang Tuhan mau lakukan di negara.
What God is about to do.
Dan saudara kamu yang mulia. Kenapa? Karena kita ditransformasi.
How?
Bagaimana?
Are you transformed?
Kita ditransformasi.
In Acts chapter 21, he gives us a secret.
Dalam kisah 21 rahasianya.
When Paul was transformed.
Waktu Paulus ditransformasi.
You know, in Acts 21, Paul says.
Dalam kisah 21.
He comes to a place in his life.
Dia datang ke suatu tempat di hidupnya.
I like this word.
Saya suka kata-kata ini.
Same word Pastor Robert always use.
Sesuatu yang Pastor Robert selalu katakan.
I don't care.
I don't care. Saya suka itu. Gua nggak peduli.
I don't care.
Gua nggak peduli
about people.
Buat orang.
I care about Jesus.
Saya peduli Yesus.
I don't care what you think.
Saya nggak peduli seorang
apa. I care what God thinks.
Saya peduli apa yang Tuhan kata.
Paul came to this place.
Paulus ada di tempat ini.
You know what he said?
Apa yang dia katakan?
I don't.
Saya tidak peduli.
I don't care about my life.
Saya tidak peduli hidupku.
Not important.
Tidak penting lagi.
Not important.
Tidak penting lagi.
Why?
Kenapa?
My burden.
Kenapa?
Is to finish the race.
Karena saya menyelesaikan
tugas
saya.
Finish my assignment.
Saya harus menyelesaikan tugas saya.
Finish my vision.
Menyelesaikan visi saya.
I finish my calling.
Saya menyelesaikan panggilan saya.
My burden.
Berbeban saya.
Is no more.
Bukan lagi.
Just things.
Ini hal dunia.
No more things.
Bukan lagi hal-hal.
But I've come to a place.
Saya sampai satu tempat.
I have been transformed.
Saya sudah ditransformasi.
You know why I know he was transformed?
Sudah kenapa saya tahu dia ditransformasi?
Whenever in church.
Di mana pun di gereja.
Whenever they celebrate communion.
Pada waktu mereka merayakan itu namanya perjamuan.
Most pastors.
Kebanyakan pendeta.
Will quote a scripture in Corinthians.
Akan ambil ayat di Korintus.
From Paul.
Dari Paulus.
Paul said.
Paulus berkata.
On the night Jesus was
betrayed. Pada malam waktu Yesus diserahkan.
He took bread.
Dia mengambil roti.
And he broke it.
Memecah-mecahkannya.
I have a problem.
Saya punya masalah. Paulus tidak ada di grup itu.
He was not even a Christian.
Dia bukan Kristen saat itu.
How he know?
Bagaimana dia tahu?
How he know?
Bagaimana dia tahu?
Jesus took the bread.
Dia Yesus ambil roti.
And broke it.
Dan memecah-mecah.
How he know?
Bagaimana dia tahu?
Because he was transformed.
Karena dia ditransformasikan.
When you are transformed,
kau ditransformasikan.
You know what happened. What is going to happen? Why? Because God shapes you. He shapes you in a spirit realm. And He removes all limitations. That's why Paul said, I am immovable. I cannot be shaken. He said there is only one thing that shakes me. It's the love of God. Love of God. He said angels, demons, history, future,
masa depan,
cannot affect me.
Tidak bisa mempengaruhi saya.
Only
cuma satu hal.
The love of God.
Cinta akan Kristus.
He had come.
Dia sampai.
So close.
Gua sangat dekat.
So close.
Sangat dekat.
Only Jesus matter.
Hal-hal Yesus saja.
Only Jesus matter.
Hal-hal Yesus saja.
You know why the Chinese church?
Saya pernah ke gereja China.
Was so powerful.
Kenapa begitu luar biasa?
I heard this story.
Saya dengar cerita.
It changed my life.
Itu merubah hidup saya.
I want to share this story.
Saya mau ceritakan ceritanya.
And I'm going to pray for you.
Saya mau doakan lalu.
For an impartation.
Suatu impartasi.
Because I believe.
Karena saya percaya.
God wants to bring you to a new level.
Dalam level yang baru.
You came to this conference.
Conference
because you want to go to a new level.
Mau masuk level yang
you didn't come to this
conference ini
just to enjoy the worship.
Cuma menikmati
or listen to preaching. You came because you want a new level.
Karena kau mau
hunger in this place.
Ada haus di tempat
ini. There is a desperation in this place. And I believe as you press when different pastors preach,
dan ketika semua pendeta yang lain berbeda berkorban,
transformation pasti terjadi. You see when transformation comes,
lalu
transformation
terjadi.
You know what it does?
Apa yang dikatakan?
It makes habitation complete.
Dan itu membuat satu tempat tinggal yang baru
complete.
Semuanya menjadi sempurna. Sempurna.
The Bible says in 2 Corinthians and chapter 5,
2 Korintus pasal 5,
and chapter 6,
pasal 6,
it says that God will clothe you.
Dan Tuhan akan memakaikan pakaian.
Clothe you.
Memakaikan
pakaian.
Dengan kemuliaan.
Clothe you with glory.
Memakaikan
glory.
Memakaikan dengan kemuliaan.
And chapter 6 says,
dan pasal 6 berkata,
you will become the temple of the living God.
Tuhan akan menjadi dari Allah di
temple of the living God.
Dari Allah di
you will carry the glory.
Kau akan membawa kemuliaan.
I heard this story.
Saya dengar cerita ini.
The story about a young woman in China.
Seorang perempuan muda di China.
She was 16 years old.
Umurnya 16 tahun.
No church.
Pergi ke gereja.
No Bible.
Nggak ada Alkitab, nggak ada gereja.
No worship team.
Nggak ada penyembahan.
She was tuning the radio, shortwave radio.
Suatu hari dia lagi betulkan radio.
She heard the message of the gospel.
Dia mendengar firman berita Injil.
She got saved.
Dan dia diselamatkan.
Every day.
Setiap hari.
Same time she listened.
Waktu yang sama dia dengar.
Dengar.
Dan kalau.
No Bible.
Gak ada Alkitab.
No church.
Gak ada gereja.
No pastor.
Gak ada gembala.
She listened.
Dia mendengar.
And then she go and tell people
dan
about
dia
Jesus.
Orang tentang Yesus.
Many people become Christian.
Banyak orang menjadi Kristen.
Many people follow her.
Banyak orang mengikuti dia.
She become a leader.
Dia jadi pemimpin.
She have no Bible.
Dia punya Alkitab.
No church.
Dia ada gereja.
She now become leader.
Dia jadi pemimpin.
And then after a few months.
Setelah beberapa bulan.
The Chinese police call her.
Polisi China memanggil dia.
They bring her to jail.
Oh, ditangkap, ditaruh di penjara.
And they beat her.
Dan mulai dipukuli.
After they beat her.
Setelah dipukuli.
They bring her home.
Dia dibawa pulang.
They say, don't preach anymore.
Jangan khotbah lagi.
She stayed at home for a few days.
Dia tinggal di rumah beberapa hari.
Listen to radio.
Dengar radio.
And strengthen her body.
Dan menguatkan tubuhnya.
She told her father and mother.
Dia kasih tahu papa mama.
I cannot preach here.
Saya nggak bisa khotbah di sini.
I go to other cities.
Saya pergi kota lain.
She take her radio.
Dia bawa radionya.
And she go to other cities.
Wow. Dia pergi ke kota lain.
Preach.
Waktu dibawa dia pulang,
she was in bad shape.
Dia sangat buruk rupanya.
And her parents still fed her, take care.
Dan orang tua terus memberi makan dia.
Strengthened
her. Dan dikuatkan.
Every day she listened to that.
Setiap hari dia dengar radio.
After 6 months.
Setelah 6 bulan.
She tell her mother and father.
Dia beritahu mama bapaknya.
I must tell people.
Sekarang saya tahu orang.
About the love of this God. How can I keep quiet?
Gimana saya bisa diam?
I have never seen such love.
Saya nggak pernah merasakan cinta seperti ini.
This God is an amazing God.
Luar biasa.
I must tell people.
Saya harus beritahu orang.
So she tell her father and mother.
Dan dia beritahu apa mamanya.
I want to go to the deepest.
Saya mau pergi ke bagian yang paling dalam. Menceritakan cintanya bapak ke bapak masnya radionya
gak
ada Amina dia pergi
every week
setiap minggu
she sent letter to her mother and father
dia kirim surat mama papanya
many people become Christian
banyak orang berikut tuh
many get saved
banyak orang yang Islam
after a few months
setelah berapa bulan
more than 400 people become
sebagai seorang jadi Kristen dengan melalui perempuan ini. 1987 bulan Oktober
she was arrested by the Chinese police.
Dia ditangkap lagi.
Her parents received a last letter.
Dia orang tua yang menerima surat terakhir.
And this is what she said.
Dan ini dia katakan.
She said, Mom. And Dad.
Papa.
I have been arrested.
Saya ditangkap.
Next month,
bulan depan,
I will be executed.
Saya akan
preaching the gospel.
Karena beritakan Injil.
You know what she said?
Apa yang dia katakan?
She said, "No more pray."
Jangan berdoa.
That I will be set free.
Supaya saya dilepaskan.
But pray.
Berdoa.
That I will preach.
Saya tetap berkhotbah. November 87
she was executed
jadi hukumati
for preaching the gospel
karena beritakan Injil
she only knew Jesus
dia cuma tahu Yesus
only 2 years
cuma 2 tahun
but in 2 years
tapi dalam 2 tahun
she was transformed
dia ditransformasi
transformed
ditransformasi
she was so changed
dia berubah
so changed
berubah
fear couldn't grip her.
Ketakutan tidak bisa menyentuh.
The prison couldn't hold her.
Penjara tidak bisa menahan dia.
The jail couldn't keep her.
Penjara tidak bisa membiarkan.
Couldn't keep her.
Tidak bisa
menahan
dia. Kenapa?
Because she was transformed.
Transformasi.
Transformed. This one woman.
Satu kata ini.
Infected.
Memakaruh. Membuat
hundreds of young people
ratusan anak muda di China
hundreds of
young beberapa ratus
only two years
cuma 2 tahun kreatif Kristen
and she started a revival
dia mulai kebangunan rohani
a revival
kebangunan rohaninya
it was another young man His name was called David Brainerd.
And
29 years old, came bringing the gospel to the American Indians. His father-in-law. Is Jonathan Edwards.
Adalah Jonathan Edwards.
The revivalist.
Itu seorang pria
kebangkitan. 29 years old.
Dan 29 tahun umurnya.
His life story.
Cerita hidupnya.
Impacted.
Memberikan impact.
Jonathan Edwards. And many of the revivalists.
Dan banyak bapak kebangkitan rohani yang lain.
What am I saying?
Apa yang saya katakan?
Blessing presence.
Hadirat yang memberkati.
Is wonderful.
Luar biasa.
God will bless you.
Tuhan berkati.
But don't stay there.
Tapi jangan stop di sana.
We need manifest presence. We need to reach out.
Kita perlu
We need to reach out. When you are changed,
waktu saudara dan saya diubah,
your city will be changed.
Kotamu akan berubah.
What is the key?
Rasanya apa?
When you come to transforming presence,
waktu anda dalam hadirat yang mengtransformasi,
you are not afraid to die anymore.
Saudara tidak lagi takut mati.
Not afraid.
Tidak takut mati.
You know, one of the greatest armies.
Satu tentara yang terbesar.
Was the army of Alexander the Great.
Adalah tentara dari Alexander, Raja Alexander.
Such a powerful army.
Dia punya tentara yang begitu luar biasa.
One time he was fighting an army that had 50,000 soldiers.
Dan dia pas suatu hari mau melawan tentara 40,000.
And he had 10,000 soldiers.
Dan dia cuma punya 10,000.
And the adversary from the 50,000 came to him.
Dan dari bukit itu 40,000 datang.
And he said,
dan dia berkata,
you have 50,000.
Engkau punya 55,000 bahkan.
I have 50,000, you have 10,000.
Aku punya 50,000, engkau punya 10,000.
You will lose.
Engkau pasti kalah.
Surely lose.
Pasti kalah.
You know, history tells us.
Dan dia cerita ini sejarah membuktikan.
Alexander didn't say anything.
Alexander yang ngomong apa?
He called his first soldier.
Dia panggil prajurit pertama. Dan dia meneriakkan.
When he whispered,
waktu dia bersiul,
the soldier,
prajurit itu,
took his sword,
ambil pedangnya,
and stabbed himself.
Dan tusuk perut
to death.
Mati.
Second soldier,
prajurit kedua,
whispered,
terus lagi ngomong.
He take his spear,
ambil tombaknya,
and he put it on the ground.
Dan taruh di tanah,
and he ran.
Dan dia lari,
and he jumped.
Dan dia loncat.
To his daddy.
Sampai mati.
He called the third soldier.
Dan ketika dipanggil.
And he said, there is a cliff.
Itu ada tepi.
I want you to run.
Aku mau lari.
And jump.
Dan loncat.
And soldier ran.
Prajurit lari.
And he jumped.
Dan loncat. Sampai mati.
He told the emissary.
Dan dia bilang emissary.
You have 50,000.
Engkau punya 50,000.
I have 10,000.
Saya punya 10,000.
But everyone I have.
Tapi semua yang saya miliki
is ready to die.
Rela mati.
Ready.
Siap untuk mati.
I command you.
Saya perintahkan engkau.
Surrender.
Menyerah.
The Bible says.
Alkitab berkata.
When a corn of wheat falls to the ground and dies.
Ketika biji gandum itu jatuh ke tanah dan mati.
Revival.
Kebangkitan rohani terjadi.
Revival will stop.
Kebangunan rohani terjadi.
For the move of God to come. For the manifestation of God to come.
Hadirat Tuhan dimanifestasikan itu datang.
We got to shift.
Kita harus pindah.
We got to shift.
Kita harus pindah.
We got to shift.
Kita harus pindah.
What a wonderful testimony today.
Bukan kita saja mendengar hal yang luar biasa.
Wonderful testimony.
Kesaksian yang luar biasa.
Pastor Robert wanted to start this conference.
Mulai conference ini.
Pastor Daniel didn't say anything.
Pastor Daniel nggak ngomong apa.
But he sent me a check.
Tapi dikirim check.
What am I saying? You must come to a place where you don't matter.
Hidup kita tidak pengaruh lagi. Tidak pengaruh lagi.
The only thing
that pengaruh kita
is Jesus.
Tuhan Yesus.
Jesus. You are not building your kingdom.
Kita nggak dirikan kerajaan kita.
His kingdom.
Kerajaan.
His glory,
kemuliaannya,
His success,
suksesnya,
and His breakthrough,
dan terobosannya.
Every head bow,
setiap kepala tertunduk, semua mata dipejam.
I do not know where you are at.
Saya nggak tahu saudara ada di mana.
But God wants to bring you,
mau membawa anda,
to different levels of glory,
kepada kemuliaan yang berbeda.
He wants to take you.
Dia membawa anda
on a journey.
Dalam satu perjalanan.
Where you become.
Ketika saudara menjadi
invincible.
Orang yang tidak terkalahkan.
Invincible.
Tidak terkalahkan.
You become.
Saudara menjadi.
So change. So change.
Diubah sedemikian rupa.
So change.
Diubah sedemikian rupa.
So transform.
Ditransformasi.
The glory of God.
Sehingga kemuliaan Tuhan
becomes your habitation.
Menjadi tempat tinggalmu.
Habitation.
Tempat kediamanmu.
Where His presence becomes.
Hadirannya.
A reality.
Menjadi realitas.
The future of Indonesia.
Masa depan Indonesia.
Is in this room.
Ada di ruangan ini.
The hope of Indonesia.
Harapan buat Indonesia
is in this room.
Ada di ruangan ini.
God called many people.
Tuhan panggil banyak orang.
But today.
Tapi hari ini.
They are distracted.
Orang-orang itu teralihkan.
They are building their own kingdom.
Mereka bangun kerajaan mereka.
They are building their own empire.
Mereka bangun kerajaannya sendiri.
But there is a new breed.
Ada satu generasi
baru,
generasi baru,
a new generation of
people baru,
in this room,
di ruangan ini,
that are tired,
yang capek,
of religion,
dengan agama,
tired,
capek,
of a hopeless,
dengan tidak ada harapan,
tired,
capek,
of things that don't work,
menjadi orang yang tidak melakukan apa-apa. Tapi sangat haus
for the glory
untuk kemuliaan
of God
dari Allah.
I tell you this.
Saya beritahu saudara.
Before you leave this meeting.
Sebelum saudara tinggalkan.
On Sunday afternoon.
Minggu sore.
The glory of God.
Kemuliaan Tuhan.
Is going to hit you.
Akan menghantam anda.
Is going to hit you.
Akan menghantam anda.
Is going to fill you.
Akan menghantam anda.
Is going to overflow.
Akan menguasai anda.
When you go back.
Ketika saudara pulang.
There will be a new attitude.
Akan ada hal yang baru.
A new attitude.
Ada suatu perasaan.
That will bring a new attitude.
Baru. Membuat suatu masa depan yang baru.
A new spirit.
Dan roh yang baru,
a new fire,
api yang baru,
a new anointing,
urapan yang baru,
a new glory,
kemuliaan yang baru.
Do not miss this.
Jangan kehilangan ini.
Do not miss this.
Jangan kehilangan ini.
I preach all over the world.
Saya berkhotbah di seluruh dunia.
All over the world.
Di seluruh dunia.
Very few times.
Beberapa kali saja.
Very few.
Sangat sedikit saja.
I meet people.
Saya ketemu orang
like this.
Yang seperti anda.
Like this.
Seperti anda.
They are hungry.
Mereka haus
for His glory.
Buat kemuliaannya. non-praying church.
Non-praying religion.
You are very blessed. Very blessed. To know this man. To know this man of God. Because this kind of men of God are very rare. Very rare. Many today are not interested in the
Messiah.
What you are interested
in,
I am telling you, take a hold of it. Take a hold of it. Press into
it.
Press into it. Tomorrow. Tomorrow morning, come. Come with desperation. Say, God, change me. Transform me.
Transformasi aku.
Bring blessing presence.
Bawa hadirat yang memberkati.
Blessing presence.
Hadirat yang memberkati.
Many of you. Many of you.
Banyak dari saudara.
Breakthrough will come.
Dan akan berkembang.
Breakthrough will come.
Terobos akan datang.
Pastor Robert said.
Pastor Robert berkata.
The wealth of the riches will come.
Kekayaan bangsa-bangsa akan mengalir.
Will come to you.
Akan datang.
Will come to you.
Akan
many of you
akan ketika saudara melihat
manifestation,
saudara akan melihat kuasa dirinya
manifestation.
When
you go back home,
kalau saudara pulang,
people will call you.
Orang akan telepon.
People you will meet on the road.
Dan orang akan mengantri.
And you see.
Dan mereka berkata,
can you pray for me?
Bisa kau berdoa?
Can you pray for me?
Bisa kau berdoa buat saya?
Can you pray for me?
Bisa kau berdoa buat saya?
Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit.
Roh Kudus.
Will set you up.
Dan saya akan membawa anda.
Will set you up.
Akan membuat anda.
Will align you.
Akan menyatukan.
Will bring you.
Akan membawa anda di garisnya.
To manifest presence.
Untuk hadirat yang
dimanifest.
Generation.
Revival generation. terjadi.
Realitas.
Realitas.
Power of God.
Kuasa Tuhan
is in this place.
Ada di tempat ini.
In this place.
Di tempat ini.
I'm going to ask the pastors to come.
Saya minta para pendeta datang.
The pastors, the leaders here to come.
Mari pemimpin datang.
Very quickly.
Cepat.
Because we're going to pray. We're not going to take a long time.
Kita tak akan lama.
We're not going to take a long time.
Kita tak akan ambil waktu lama.
But yeah, just going to touch. Touch.
Saya mau cuma anda.
Touch.
Cama.
Touch.
Cama.
Touch.
Cama.
I want you to reach out.
Saya mau saudara anakku.
I want you to reach out.
Mau menjangkau. Sekarang.
I want this.
I want this.
I want this.
I want this.
This is my day.
Ini adalah hariku.
This is my hour.
Ini adalah waktuku.
To receive an impartation.
Untuk menerima impartasi.
Of the presence of God.
Hadirat Tuhan.
If you are hungry.
Kalau kau haus.
Very quickly.
Cepat.
Run to the
front.